Hey guys, in this video, we're going to be introduced to two of the most important tools in a physicist's mathematical toolbox, vectors and scalars. So let's dive right into it. So what is a vector? Well, vectors are mathematical quantities that are fully described by a magnitude and a direction. What do we mean by magnitude? Well, that's just really the size or quantity of something. If you can have more or less of something, if it can be measured on a scale, or if it can be bigger or smaller, then it has a magnitude. And what about direction? Well, that's simple. It's an indication of how something is oriented in space. Examples are right and left, up and down, or even east and west, as well as north and south. In mathematics, variables that are vectors usually have an arrow on top of them. So, if the variable v were a vector, we'd put an arrow above it, like this, to represent that it is, in fact, a vector quantity. Great! So here's a simple example of a vector. Suppose a friend is asking how to get to the grocery store, and we tell them, it's half a kilometer north of here. At a glance, it might look like we just gave them one piece of information, telling them where to go. But in reality, it actually consists of two pieces of information. First, we told them it's half a kilometer from here. Second, we also mentioned that it's north of here. The first piece of information was the distance. It can be bigger or smaller. It's a quantity, in other words, a magnitude. The second piece was obviously the direction. And hey, remember what a vector is? Something that has magnitude and direction. So when we said it's half a kilometer north of here, we were really giving our friend the vector 0.5 kilometers north. Awesome. All right. Now, say another friend comes to visit, and they notice that you've got 42 books on your bookshelf. So, the number of books that you have, is it considered a vector quantity? Well, the answer is no. See, even though there is a magnitude involved, and even though you can have more or less books, there's no direction here. Therefore, it is not a vector, since vectors must involve a direction. In fact, quantities that involve a magnitude but no direction are called scalars. Here's a fact that might come in handy. Every vector has a scalar associated with it. And this makes sense because a scalar quantity is one with only magnitude. But a vector involves a magnitude as well as a direction. So we can actually think of a vector as a scalar quantity that also involves a direction. In fact, there is even a special way to indicate the magnitude of a vector. And that is, for any vector v, we denote its magnitude by putting two lines on either side of it, like so. And like we mentioned earlier, this arrow denotes that this is a vector. Good. Let's go over one last example. We go online, check the weather, and find that the wind is blowing south at 30 kilometers an hour. Would this be considered a vector quantity? Of course it is. And why? Well, that's because it contains a magnitude, which corresponds to the speed of the wind. The wind could be faster or slower, and it also tells us where the wind was blowing. In other words, the direction of the wind. Again, magnitude and direction together give us a vector. Awesome! Now we know what a vector quantity is. It's simply any mathematical quantity that involves both a magnitude and a direction. We also briefly went over what a scalar quantity is and how it is a quantity that only represents magnitude. In the next lesson, we'll learn how to mathematically represent vector quantities. So, until next time, have a good one.